Good morning, and I'd like to welcome everyone to this, the 8th meeting of the Standards, Procedure and Public Appointments Committee in 2022. I would like to remind those members who are joining us virtually to place an R in the chat function of BlueJeans if they would like to come in on any issues. Agenda item 1 today is for the committee to agree to take agenda item 4 in private. This item is for the committee to consider some correspondence. Are members in agreement to do that? Excellent, thank you. Our second agenda item today is for the committee to consider an application for recognition from a proposed cross-party group on care leavers. And I'd like to welcome Paul O'Kane, MSP, to this meeting. Paul is the proposed convener of the group and is joining us remotely. Good morning. Would you like to set out the purposes and intentions of the CPG, Paul?
Thank you, convener, and good morning to colleagues in committee. I'm very pleased to be here this morning and to share with you the intentions of the cross-party group on care leavers. Essentially, the establishment of this group, convener, was around, I think, a sense that there wasn't a dedicated focus for care leavers within in the Parliament. We obviously have a number of cross-party groups that I think cater in terms of children who are currently looked after, and indeed other cross-party groups that cross-cut around social work and other issues. However, I think there was a sense that young people who are leaving the care system and young people who have dedicated experiences of being in the care system didn't have a voice within the cross-party group system. So essentially, within the summary of the papers, the purpose of the group is to inform MSPs of the many social, emotional, wellbeing and financial challenges which care leavers face via the forum of the CPG, which will essentially seek to share information and knowledge about the experiences of care leavers and those who support them. We will work in collaboration across the other cross-party groups I've mentioned, particularly, I think, a strong relationship with the cross-party group on social work. We intend to have a wide membership that's drawn from young people with lived experience and indeed adults who have also went through the care system. And essentially, we will seek to express their views, opinions and ideas to both government and Parliament, and share their vision for what Scotland can be. And I think a core part of this also, convener, is the work that we are all committed to on the promise. I think there's a sense that the cross-party group would want to contribute to the progress of the promise and the scrutiny of the promise and ensure that we as decision makers and wider civic society in Scotland keep the promise that we made to care experienced young people and those leaving care across Scotland. And there'll be a number of other related issues which we will discuss. But I think in summary, essentially this is about putting on the map and ensuring that a very underrepresented group very often is represented in our Parliament. Thank you, convener.
Thank you, Paul. And I know that one of the organisations that's signed up to the CPG is staff, and it was lovely to see them displaying in the garden lobby and meeting with MSPs to discuss that. Do any committee members have any specific questions on this matter? Were you surprised, Paul, that this was the first time that care leavers group was being proposed? Did it come as a surprise?
It did, convener. I mean, I must say, I think given the remarks I've just made about the importance to us all of the promise, and I think the degree in which I think the profile of people who have care experience and indeed the care system more generally has been at the forefront in the last few years, I was quite surprised, but I think it is definitely of its time. I think it will provide a strong forum for us, as I say, as decision makers, to continue to scrutinise that journey and to support the voices experienced young people. And I would also just like to thank you, convener, for reminding colleagues that staff are in Parliament this week. Their stall continues today, and indeed we have an event this evening, so I'll just abuse my position slightly to plug that event if colleagues are around at 5:30 this evening.
That was not in any way set up much. Right. Thank you for attending, Paul. The committee will consider whether or not to approve the application for recognition at agenda item 3, and the clerks will inform you of due course of the committee's decision. But can I thank you for attending today?
Thank you, convener.
Agenda item 3 is indeed to decide whether or not we wish to afford credit to the proposed cross-party group on care leavers. Do any committee members have any comments, questions or views on that? Okay, I'll come to Bob first, then you, Colette. Bob.
Sorry, apologies, Governor. Just a very brief comment. I nearly asked a question to Mr. O'Kane, but I didn't think it was required, but we just put on the record that I think this cross-party group could be of a good service to the committees of the Parliament as well, because I also sit on the Education Committee, and the promise is clearly something the Education Committee is clearly going to have a scrutiny role in relation to the delivery of it. We won't always find the time to give that as much time as we'd like to, so I think the work of the cross-party group would certainly complement the work of the main committees of the Parliament. I think we've all got that responsibility to make sure we deliver on the promise. So in that context, I think it's very welcome that this cross-party group is going to hopefully okay, be established in the Parliament.
I think you make an interesting comment, Bob, because this committee's heard on a number of different matters the challenge of actually hearing evidence, particularly from experienced lived witnesses, and maybe it would be an opportunity not just if this proposed CPG goes forward, but to look at some of the resource that sat in some of our CPGs when we're looking for evidence across committees. Colette, can I invite you to come in?
Yeah, I just want to put on the record that I am actually a member of that CPG based on it gets accepted. But also as well, my background in the past prior to being elected was actually working for a care experience charity who'd three care homes throughout Scotland. And it's something that's really, really close to my heart. It's so welcoming to see this and to be able to be a voice for these young people. I've seen firsthand the challenges that they faced. One of the things that sort of stood out for me, and it's something that I would like to see going forward, is that within any care home setting, although the local authority is the corporate parent there, there's no potential will for any of the care staff to make sure that the young people are going to school and getting a proper education, per se. It's not incumbent on them. The other thing that stood out for me as well was the fact that they were very reluctant to register to vote, which I found quite concerning as well, because they felt that Big Brother was watching them and that the police would be onto them for various different things. So it's something I'm really passionate about and something keen to take forward and bust any myths in association with that.
I like your comment on busting any myths, and the record notes your potential interest in the CPG. Are members agreed, therefore, to accord recognition to this proposed cross-party group on care leavers?
Yes.
Yep. We're all agreed with that. Thank you. I'm now going to close the public part of this meeting, and the committee will move into private.